fate has smiled on these teams once, which team will catch your eye again in this second round matchup between the Yale Bulldogs and the Oregon Ducks?
It's showtime, baby. Let's skip the intros and get this one started.
You got it, partner. So without any further delay, let's get this one started. The Ducks should be able to put this team away early, Dick. What's the key to them doing that tonight?
Hey, Brad, for them tonight, the keys are as follows. Number one, the point guard has to be the floor general. It's up to him to ensure that his team executes and has efficiency on both sides of the floor. Secondly, make good decisions offensively and reduce those turnovers. Lastly, keep it simple defensively and play as a unit.
All right, there you have it. Let's get to the action, see what's in store for us. He pump fakes. There they come with a double team to stop it. Number 22 handles the feed. Both teams looking to get things going here. Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I'll tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help some.
Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Got an open look if he wants it. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
Trying to feed inside. They go inside, and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
He goes with a jump hook.
I tell you, didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position, and then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn.
Adam. Momentary look from three-point land. Perfectly executed. The shot from the baseline. Way off target. Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Number four receives the pass. He hits the shot. Number 22 is emotionally fired up.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you should be afraid to show your emotions.
As one of the better players on the team's roster, he's expected to make big plays, isn't he, Dick?
Hey, Brad, he's expected to do all the things that will put them in a position to win at the end of the day.
Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset.
The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad. Trying to go inside.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
It's a fast break possibility. Goes up for two. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. Dumps it in.
That was a great effort right there. Trying to play that passing lane. Anticipating really well.
Down in the low post defensively. Great anticipation in the steal.
You can see they did a great job studying in film. They anticipated that ball coming to that post.
From the baseline. Off the rim and no good. Dickie's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball and man.
On the dribble, gives it up. They'll work it around the arc. Got a nice screen. He puts up the tray. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Hey, if it wasn't for his play, that'd be in big trouble, Brad. Someone else needs to step up.
Steals a pass. Long down court pass.
Nice job to create the angle using the glass. They say forget about it, and then he does a little dribbling act here and turns it over.
He makes the shot.
They scored seven in a row.
They look to get it to the inside. Makes a move and goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul. There.
He's out of control, baby, out of control.
Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
He shoots from outside. They're dialing threes up like nothing right now.
Hey, this is awesome to watch, baby.
See who will benefit the most out of that timeout, Dick. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again.
Dump it inside.
He goes for three. He gets that one to fall.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Looking to move it around the perimeter.
High post screen. So effective, that screen.
Can't get the shot to go. The Ducks have a special roster, which I know you're in love with, Dick.
Oh, their roster is pretty special, Brad. You know why? Because of the seniors, the leaders, the dependable ones. They're so important.
Gave it up. Number 00 is called for the foul. First personal foul. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, both teams appear to be really focused as they return to their benches. This is it for one of these teams, and as you guys frequently say, it's do or die, guys.
The ball goes out of play. Full house. And a packed crowd, and they are into it tonight.
I tell you, what emotion, what an edge for the home team.
Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Leans in. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Both teams looking to get things going. The power forward handles the pass. For the bucket.
I tell you, once you get deep position like that, it's automatic.
Number 33 is whistled for the foul. First personal foul. The Ducks are going to be at the line for the first time in this game. Gets his first. Both free throws go. Working it around the perimeter. Now the high screen. He takes the shot off the baseline. Gets the rebound.
Once you get that board, you've got to be looking up court.
He missed on the steal. That's going to be the offense's game.
Yes, sir. They got the advantage right there once he misses that gamble.
What should they do here, Dick?
I'd call a timeout and see what's going on out there. There's definitely some miscommunication happening.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play.
There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Number 10 receives the ball. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket. Not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player. Poor job offensively. If I'm coaching, he's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball to the deck. Where's he going?
On the dribble, gives it up. They work it around the perimeter. Let's watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first initially he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebounding position, a good block out. And that's essential in the post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately to block out and get good rebound position.
He shoots from left of the circle. You betcha. He tries the three. Way off target.
Hey, did you see what the mascot was doing after the last dunk? Was he excited or what? He was jumping all over the place.
Looking for a good shot. Number 23 fakes the shot. And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? Number one makes a great move to draw the foul. And he's going to pick up the foul. And oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Goes to the line, shooting two. Makes the first shot. And he got them both. Moving it around the perimeter. He tries to knock down the three. He's just not seeing the floor, Dick.
He doesn't want to, Brad. He wants to score, and I'll tell you, that ain't good for team morale, baby.
They work it back to the outside. He shoots from downtown. What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Let's see if they go two for one here, Dick. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing them to make that turn.
Now they work it around the perimeter.
High post screen.
Easy one. Shot clock is dead. Defense made him keep it too long. Ball coming in from the sideline. Shots that he blocks the shot.
That's basic.
Goes for the deep one. Goes. The half. The Ducks are up by 12. This one's been a nail biter so far, Dick. What play do you think set the tone in the first half, in your opinion?
The threes were the key for me, Brad. In my books, this shot sparked morale more than anything. When you're hitting threes, everything else comes a lot easier.
Well, partner, let's get back to the game and see how this one plays out. Number four provided the offensive spark for the team in the first half, Richard.
Absolutely. He's simply trying to put his squad in the best possible position to win this ball game. How much more can you ask from a star player?
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. And he goes with a spin. Up and in.
Little showtime. It's going to be a three-point play. Got the foul. The bench loves it.
With the freebie. Lots of rim, but not in. He makes a nice shot fake. Here's the toss back out from the post.
That's our coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
For the bucket. Basket falls despite the contact. Good job defensively. They just won't give him any openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
For the deuce. And in and out. Guy in the post, but elected to reverse the ball from three-point territory. Off the rim and no good. He was looking for the call and he got it on himself. Offensive foul.
Definitely an offensive foul, no doubt about it. He beats him to the spot.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
He unloads.
Great job of running the defender into the screen for the nice J.
And working around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Sinks the shot. Two.
Unbelievable. Look at that post position. He can't get a piece of that, baby.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
Dick, at defense looks tired.
Hey, that's no excuse. They've got to dig down deep and get the job done.
Looking for a good shot. Dickey's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
And he tries to spin away from the defender.
I tell you, he's versatile in the post. He's got the spin move and a number of other activities.
In the paint. Makes the move and goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul. Man.
He's out of control, baby, out of control.
Takes the pass in the paint. He does the sweet fake shot. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
He's good for another score.
Hands in his face. Any time now, boys?
Leaning in, trying to draw contact. That comes off. Might have been some contact on the shot. On the outside. Tries for two. In and out. Here's a double team. Rims out. Moving it around the perimeter. He's got a nice shot fake. He fires from long range. Off the rim and no good.
Dumping inside.
Jumps into the defender. Yale are on a run right here as of late, Dick.
Yeah, they've started to put it together on offense. Can they keep it together, though? That is the question.
The shooting guard gets the ball. Good fake. Takes the pass in the paint. Gets it back out. 10 seconds left on the shot clock.
Not getting enough motion.
He got the bucket and the foul.
Hey, the foul in the air couldn't stop him, baby. He wanted that bucket.
What a play. These kids are fired up now. And if you're going to celebrate, why not celebrate with a teammate?
Hey, why not? It's a team sport, right?
He goes to the line for the first time. Gets it. He's got some room. He goes for three. He gets that one to fall. Gave it up. Picks off the pass. On the dribble, gives it up. Dick, we all know how important it is to get to the free throw line.
Well, there's no doubt about it. I think it's such an unbelievable plus. It means you're playing aggressive basketball, you're playing attacking basketball, and you're creating all kinds of foul problems for the opponent.
Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job in post position of spreading his body and getting the ball.
Go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, guys, after all, this is the NCAA finals. In talking with both coaches before the game, they figured it would be a close game from start to finish. I'm certainly looking forward to the game's ending.
Goes up for two, blows right by him.
That's the old Matador defense. Let the ball go through.
Picked out of the air. The Ducks will have their fans going silly if they can get a stop here. He up fakes. He takes the shot from the baseline. Off the mark. He may be in trouble here. He attempts the three. Nice shot. If they can get a basket here, Dick, this crowd will erupt. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. This one might go down to the final buzzer.
You've got to love these close ones, Brad. Every error is magnified and could be the difference between a win or a loss.
Gets it back out. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Got the high pick. For two. Rims out. Steals the pass. It's good. He drew the foul off a hard take to the hoop.
Nice job, young man.
He goes to the line. Up and in. Momentary look from three-point land. Kicks it out. He strokes it. The Ducks have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple. I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box. Double team now, bad angle.
Dick, let's take a look right now at our backcourt production.
Hey, team success depends on backcourt production, Brad. If you can handle the rock, make good decisions, penetrate, and knock down the open jumper, you give yourself a great opportunity to get to the winner's circle.
Second shot is good. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. He pulls the trigger. Off the rim and no good. He shoots from outside. Yale are putting together a pretty good run here.
Execution's been the key, baby.
The Ducks are going to call a timeout. And with that, we got a break. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, guys, I'm sure the coaches are using this time to go over crucial end-of-game strategy. Now, often teams will dedicate parts of their practice to special situations and end-of-game strategy. Now's the time when that practice will pay off, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. We get ready to bounce back into action here. The lead is 5. What happens now, Dick?
Well, this is where momentum can swing in your favor or go against you enough to blow your game.
Takes the pass in the paint. Tries the turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Tries for 2. He pulls down the board. The power forward takes the feed. Jumped in front to take it away. The center with the ball. Cross court. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Dick, look at this. He's not afraid to let anyone know how he feels.
Oh, Mr. Nestler, that's a no-no.
Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. There's a double team waiting there. Well, Dick, it looks like they're going to spend a little bit of time fouling right here.
It looks like they're going to slow the game down by fouling, Brad.
How important is it to get to the free throw line?
Well, you know, those bonus points, Brad, you get those simple points. They add up at the end. Plus, you get people into foul trouble.
Second one, good. That line is really being good to them tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
Get back out on the floor. Dick, what do you do with a 7-point lead?
Yeah, they keep playing and continue to do what's gotten them this far, Brad. Can't change now.
He shoots from the baseline.
Don't waste a lot of time. Foul right away.
I don't even know if you and I can find a seat in this place, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing, you get the home court advantage when you got a crowd like this. By the way, you and I have the best seat in the house.
Number 15 going to the charity line for the first time tonight. Makes the foul shot. He makes the second shot. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad. Up and inside.
He tries the 3. That's definitely not the shot they were looking for, Dick.
Well, I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
Looking for a good shot. Working it around the perimeter on the outside. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Well, Dick, sometimes statistics lie, but in this tournament game, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going on.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Bulldogs graduates to the Sweet 16 now with 2 big wins in the first round.
Let me tell you, the coach has really lit a fire under the bellies of his players. Their opponents better come to play in the third round because these kids will be ready.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.